Hey, man.
Hey.
Welcome back.
Thanks.
How was your trip?
It was great. Thank you.
Good to see you.
You too.
Oh. You want to get in on the loving?
Hey, buddy. Wow.
Yeah, she looks a little different, huh?
A little bit different without the molds in. Holy moly. Wow, you got a lot done this summer.
Yeah, man. We've been busy. We've been busy. How was your trip?
It was great.
Yeah, you guys have a good time?
Yeah, it was a good relaxation. We just lived in the van for a while and just traveling without really seeing anybody and kind of hitting cool spots along the country. It was really, really, really nice.
Nice.
So I think I'm ready to get back to this.
Yeah, I'm ready to have you back for sure.
So what do we got? Show me in here.
Well, let's see. You heard about the cedar debacle.
Yep.
So we ripped all that off and started putting the oak planks on. And Aaron and I got into a pretty good groove on that. So we were making two planks in a day and then hanging it in like 2 days. But nice. We just got to wait for the oak to dry. So unfortunately, that's going to have to wait till the spring. But there's plenty we can do till then.
Oh, I'm sure.
And then, we put in some temporary bracing, popped the molds out, bent in the rest of the frames. As you can see, there's four cedar planks on.
Yeah.
Got the frames bent in, and then what do we do after that? Clamp, the breast hooks, and the shelf, and the deck beams, the Samson post, and we dropped the diesel in. And it fits on the engine beds like we made the engine beds to fit it, which we did, so that worked well.
That looked great.
So yeah, I think the next real big thing is like this entire deck structure has to come out. And everything needs to be varnished, and some of it needs to be sanded and sealed and then varnished. And then when that's done, we can fit the knees that are gonna support the middle of the house and stiffen up that long house carlin.
Mm-hmm.
And then hopefully in the next, like, I don't know, 2 weeks, we can start on the house. And I'd love to get the house done up before the weather gets real cold. If we can get the house done before the weather gets real cold, we got a whole lot of options through the winter of bronze and bulkheads and potentially diesel, and there's all sorts of stuff that we can skip around and work on. So yeah, it's kind of the goal.
Perfect. Let's do it.
Sweet. So Alix and I are both back in the boathouse after a bit of a break. So he was gone for the summer. And I heard all summer long, when's Alix back? When's Alix back? And the answer was always in the fall. He'll be back in the fall. And he came back in the fall. So here, fall is defined by when the leaves change color. The leaves are changing color. They're falling off now. And look who's here.
Here
I am. So on time, as promised, back to the grind. So how was your trip?
It was great. And it was awesome. Obviously, right now is kind of a funky time to travel with COVID and everything, but surprising thing is that living in a van is kind of perfect for that. So it was a sweet quarantine vehicle and home for us for the last couple of months. We stayed away from as many people as possible and basically just traveled around and found remote places to go hang out and go do adventures. And honestly, it was very much needed and was really great. We avoided pretty much all the cities. We hit a ton of national parks all across the country. And honestly, it was a way to kind of decompress. So I didn't really take any video just because that was my way of kind of just letting go of that. But it's been really awesome coming back because while we were out there, like I said, completely disconnected. So the only things I saw were like here and there, little posts on Facebook and Instagram and a video here and there. So this is insane. I am super impressed with the work that Steve did. This looks really, really good. And I'm so psyched to see Arabella without her molds in there and be able to see her shape and be able to walk in and on and around her. Like, this is just so cool. I'm so excited.
Yeah, so a lot of people were wondering why Alix took off for so long. And there was a lot of comments about he ditched me and abandoned the project and wasn't coming back. And we didn't even bother addressing them because they're so far from fact that why bother? So as you can see, he's back. And if any of you have ever tried to do a big, long-term, uncertain project and tried to do it with your best friend while living together and working 60, 80-hour work weeks every week, just imagine how that would go. So for Alix and I, it's gone pretty well. I mean, we've made it 4 years and we're still both
here.
And we still like each other. But having a break in there is important and getting a little bit of time and a little bit of space. So the other thing to consider is that when Arabella is done, Arabella will be my boat. There will be one name on the title and that will be mine.
And that was discussed ahead of time.
Yeah, that's been how it's been set up for us for the get-go. Mm-hmm. So it's my dream to build the boat. It's my family's trees. It's my family's property. It was my idea, and I asked Alix to come help me do that. And I thought it would be a great adventure, and we would both benefit greatly from it. So part of his entire summer off with Kira to go travel and explore was a little bit of me saying, like, hey, I got it. The boat is at a point where I can do a bunch of work by myself and with a volunteer. Alix had taught me enough about the cameras that I could do a halfway decent show for a few months. And I said, hey, go. I'll take the reins. I'll run it. You know, you've earned this. You deserve this. Go take some time off. Go have some fun. And that was something that we had talked about from the get-go. So we were planning on it. We weren't exactly sure when it would happen and exactly how it would happen. But the boat got to where the boat needed to be, and Alix met Kira at about the perfect time, and she was planning on road tripping anyways, so it was like, great, stars aligned, get the hell out of here, have some fun, I'll see you in the fall.
Like we said, like, for a big project like this, anybody doing this, you've got to plan in that mental health time. You know, we said 4 years, 4 years of living together, working 60 plus hours a week, like, it gets to be a lot. And it's not necessarily a bad thing, but you need to know that it's coming. So this trip was really necessary. And honestly, I think that we'll be much better for it now. And now we're both like back here, we're ready to hit it hard, and he's gonna have to take a break next. So we just wanna let you guys know, coming up, it's not gonna be immediate, but Steve's gonna take a little break at some point, and I'll do pretty much what he did while he's gone, just kind of take care of everything and start working on things. So that'll be something to look forward to.
Yeah, so Alix and I will be here together for, I don't know, the next 3 to 6 videos, something like that. We haven't set any firm dates yet. Basically, get him all caught up to speed on what I've done and what direction we're heading in. And once he's all good with that, I'm going to step out for, I don't know, 3-4 weeks, something like that, and just get out of here and probably disappear in the woods for a while. And I'm sure after 2 or 3 weeks, I'm going to be foaming at the mouth to get back here. And I'm going to try to stay away for the 4 weeks. We'll see if I even make it. And for us, it's kind of like the halftime break. So it's not halfway through the build, or maybe a quarter, a third of the way through the build. But we're halfway, maybe even a bit more than halfway through the project itself. So, you know, you got to factor in designing the logo and creating the website and cutting down trees and milling lumber and building the building and collecting the tools and restoring them, getting that all up and running. Like, all of that was, I mean, years worth of effort. So now we're at the point where all of that is done. The timber is here. We've got plenty. It's all dried. The machinery is set up. We've got the support that we need. All of that is going fairly well. We've got Ben, who's doing the video editing and doing a great job at it. So now all we really need to do is focus on making videos and focus on building the boat, which is a big shift. Even 4 months ago, we weren't really in that position. Mm-hmm. So it's a good time to just kind of like take a beat, step back for a minute, and come back and refreshed and charged towards the finish line, which we're both really looking forward to do. But we want to make sure that we're in a condition that we get there without burning out, because there are a lot of projects like this. There are a lot of builds. They get to about this point, a little more, and they never finish. And you see these hulls that are up for sale, and people just go, 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 and they don't build in any me time, and they just get burnt out. And we're not there yet. We're not burnt out, but we're making sure that we don't get burnt out. It's definitely a preemptive strike. So, yeah, let's get to work. We got to rip this deck structure out, get it all varnished, and probably do the housetop after that.
Yeah, so I'm psyched to get to work.
All right, let's do it.
Let's do it.
for the mast framing, mast blocking.
Maybe.
Yes! You want to put that right down on the ground.
Yep.
I'll come down and give you a hand. Welcome back to the Arabella fitness program.
Yep, I needed this.
Keep you lean and mean.
So Steve and I just got these out of the boat and out of the boathouse and set up here. I'm gonna work on getting these a little cleaned up with Scotch-Brite pads and 320 sandpaper, or 220, and just kind of getting them soft, rubbing them down with denatured alcohol, and then sealing them with a sealer so that tomorrow we can varnish them. So I'm gonna throw on some tunes and get to work. We've got a real gray, drizzly day here today at the boathouse. It is definitely perfect fall weather for me. We can't really do much outside in terms of varnishing, which is what we were doing to the deck beams, but no worries, we've got plenty of work we can do inside. So I'm gonna head in there and start working on some knees that we were restoring from Victoria that'll go underneath the house sides and kind of support that. So using Steve's pattern here, I marked out what we're going to remove on Victoria's old knees and how we're going to build them out. So we got a couple considerations to take into account here. There's a lot of rot on the edges, especially where the bolts went through. So this one right here, which was the worst of the two knees, we're taking out a lot on the edges to square them up. And as you can see, this one had a big included branch or something in it. So that's all gonna come out on this one. And that pretty much cleans this one out. All the edges here that are rotten are gonna get cut right out on that first go. And then this is gonna get built out with probably three pieces on this one on each side. Whereas this knee, which was much nicer, much better condition, we are just going to take out a little bit on the edges to square those off and be able to glue on some more layers. And this one, I think, is only going to take two layers to build it up to where we need it. So you can see this, just I'm taking off a real little bit here. The problem with this knee is that the edges of the wings here had nails in them, which look like they're iron, and so there's a lot of damage back there. And since we're not cutting all the way back here because we'd lose all this timber, we're gonna glue in some little pieces on the ends here to fix those. And then the last thing is the difference in shape for the jogs here compared to Victoria's, which was just a simple square right here. We're gonna have to square this off and glue in a piece here. And this doesn't matter, these little guys on the ends, because the whole thing is gonna get bolted together and sandwiched, and they're gonna get glued to these bigger pieces here, because this is all gonna get built out much farther than what this already is. And then the shape's gonna change a little bit.
Man, bronze is heavy. So, Alix is working on restoring a pair of Victoria's knees, and those are gonna go midship, right in the center of the house. They're going to help support that long carlin alongside the house. So while Alix is working with the hack and tack and cutting all that up and getting the graving pieces put in and working on restoring those knees, I'm jumping ahead a little bit and I'm going to start going through our window port light options.
So we scrapped Victoria, which you might remember. She was a Atkin Eric built in the 1920s. So we have all the port lights and dead lights from her. And then we've also cut up 3, 4, 5, I lost count, fiberglass boats. And we got a bunch of port lights from them. We've also been gifted things throughout the project. And we've just been taking it all and piling it away in the garage and waiting for the day when we decide what of it we want to use and where we want it to go. And that day is coming up shortly. Once we get the rest of the deck structure varnished and permanently installed, we can put in these knees that Alix is working on now. And then the next thing we're going to tackle is the house sides. And we're going to do those a little less traditionally. We're going to strip build those. So before we go and strip build the sides, we need to know where all the port lights are going to go. Before we can decide where all the port lights are going to go, we got to figure out actually what we have for port lights.
So this is indeed what we have to work with for port lights and dead lights. I just got to kind of think about how we want to lay this out. So I think if we put, these ones are from Vicky. Put two on the very forward end of the house. Okay. So that would be two at the front end of the house, three down either side of the house, and one in the aft end of the house opposite the cockpit, or the companionway rather. I think that would work. And then that still gives us all of these to play with. All right. Another thing we could do is put these two small ones on the front of the house. And then we could put the big ones from Victoria, four of them down the side of the house, and put our one rogue one on the aft end of the house next to the companionway. I think I might like that even better. And then these were originally in Victoria's cockpit, and I think we'll put them back in the cockpit and maybe add in these pair of deadlights as well. So that aft engine area is gonna be pretty dark, and there's really gonna be almost no natural light that gets back there. And you also wanna have ventilation for the engine compartment. So having the two small port lights that you could open up and help, you know, get some of the heat out of that engine compartment would be a good thing. Also can hear the engine a little bit easier. And having the two port lights and the two dead lights built into the sides of the cockpit also just gets more natural light back there. So if you're working on the engine, you've got a little bit of light. If, I don't know, things start to get smoky in there, you can see that the engine compartment's filling up with smoke. It's just be nice to have a visual into that compartment and have some natural light that goes in there. So I think if those two dead lights and two little port lights get mounted into the sides of the cockpit, we do four down the house, we do one in the aft end and two in the fore end, I think that'll work pretty well, and the motif of all of these go very well together. I'm not a huge fan of these oval ones. They're not in the greatest of shape. And I think we'll keep them all round. Same thing with these ones that we pulled off the Pearson. I just don't think they're quite gonna look right. But I think this should do it. So that gives an idea of what we need to do for what we have for the port lights. And I'm gonna keep ruminating on this over the next few days as we get ramped up to build the house sides. Like everything, I kind of want a picture of what's going to happen, what we have to work with, and the time to really be able to mull it over, because I might come up with some different idea in the next few days. But it's good to know what we have. It's all laid out here, and when we start to mock up the house sides, we can just grab these and put them on there and see how they look. So I'm going to go check in with Alix and see how he's making on those knees.
Alright, so I've been trying to figure out the pieces we're going to need to build these knees up. So we milled up most of the larch that we had to be dimensioned so that we could do this, It doesn't seem like it is quite enough, so we're gonna have to do a little bit more, but I'm finishing up the knee that was in worse shape because that one's gonna need more glue ups. What I did is marked out all the pieces, so they just need to be cut out. I've got them marked for where they're gonna go. And we've got a couple pieces that can't really be used. There's like big checks in here. And the issue is that a lot of it is just not getting used. Some of these are too small, or they hit some knots, but I think we got some good stuff here. So I am going to take all of these pieces and cut them out, make sure that they're all gonna fit properly before we actually try to put it together and glue it up. And then what I'm gonna do is, before I do any of the glue up, I wanna clean up the bolt holes here that got a little punky and funky. So I'll see if we wanna drill those out and put a core in afterwards or before the glue up. I'll check in with Steve, see how he feels about that. And so that's what I'm gonna do now. Run down to the table saw, not my favorite tool, and take apart some of these pieces, use the bandsaw for some maybe. But we have a beautiful new cabinet saw and I'm excited to use it even though they kind of scare me. So here goes.
Any guesses what these are for? I'm sure as I've been making these, you've been wondering. Any ideas? They are not seriously hardcore freshman paddles, and there's a whole lot more of them that need to get made. So if you haven't quite figured it out yet, these are gonna become tie rods in the boat. So this end will get attached to the shelf and to the clamp. This end will get threaded, and I'm gonna wait until we see exactly where it lands and exactly how far I have to thread it before we do the threading. So let's take these down into the boat and I can show you what I'm talking about. So we want to put a tie rod that goes from the shelf here into our carlin, and that keeps this gap where I'm in right now from spreading. Because connecting the carlin, or connecting the short beam rather here, to the carlin, there's not a really good way to fasten it. We're going to throw one screw in the end grain to help register everything, but you're not going to want to put much spreading force on that. We could put dovetails here, but same deal. Just because of how few dovetails there are and how much load there is, the chances of just shearing those dovetails off is quite probable. So the traditional solution for this is a tie rod. Now, one of our troubles with this is that the way this boat was designed, the shelf sits on top of the clamp and the deck beams sit on top of the shelf, which makes constructing the deck quite simple and great design in that regard. But when it comes time to put the tie rods in, our carlin up here is substantially higher than our shelf.
So to drill through the carlin and to drill through the shelf is gonna put it at a weird angle, and we're not gonna be able to drill through the center of the shelf. We're gonna kind of pop out through the bottom somewhere. And I don't think that's really ideal. So the solution is this plate welded onto the bronze rod. So on the end here, we'll put in this big old screw, and that'll go through the shelf and all the way down into the clamp. And then we've got two holes here where we'll put in some 3/8 bolts. I have to order some short machine bolts, and those will go through the shelf. This end, once we see exactly how far we need to thread, we'll thread it, and it'll get a nut and a washer. And the rod here will have a bit of a flexibility to kind of make up any small difference in angle between the hole we put in the timber and the plate here. And with locust being such a hard, tight-grained wood, and the fact that it's through-bolted at every frame, so 1 foot on center all the way down the boat, the chances of us splitting that locust shelf, I think, are slim to none. This should be plenty strong. It's a really simple solution, and I think it will work quite well. Thankfully, welding these up is pretty quick. There's not much to it. And although it is a substantial amount of bronze, we need to order quite a bit more. The plate and the rod aren't huge, so it's not super crazy outrageous. Right now, I just made the two of them, so we can install the carlin here and the short beam after we take them out and seal them. And when Alix is done with the knees, we can put the knee in here, we can put the tie rod in, lock this carlin in really well, and then we can get to work on the house structure, which would be pretty cool. I'm excited to launch into that. Yeah, getting the gas tank bolted back on. Yeah, right up here. Perfect, that is it. Thank you, sir.
Now what are you doing, cutting a hole?
No, varnishing.
You be warming?
It's on the low side, but yeah. I can apply it as long as it's over 40.
Oh, so it's good for 50 or better.
Yep.
So next week, Steve and Alix will press on, varnishing and all that needs to be done to the deck beams. And Steve is around for the next few episodes before getting a much-needed break of his own. Thanks for all the support that makes this project possible. And if you'd like to help us bring these videos to you for free every week, I hope you'll consider joining your fellow fans on Patreon. And see you next week.